Good day everybody and welcome to Noob Gaming. Today we are going to play with the Prime List. I'll be continuing onwards with the live stream that we started about 2 days ago. Unfortunately yesterday I couldn't really play online with because there was that patch that they had to release and all of that, so I am going to try and continue onwards with my Prime List. The build that I am trying at the moment is a totem build. Sorry for if it's a little bit rough around the edges, but I am trying to get this right. See where we left off. Kittering Valley, the last refuge. Okay. That's lots of. Oh, I have a fourth skill that I can use, which I have not started using yet. I have some Thorn Totem at the moment, and I have. Need a. Third. Now create an upheaval totem that attacks with upheaval from it rather than yourself. You are okay. Let's go for this. Upheaval. So I can specialize into it. And then two in there, one. Okay. Mana costs 150% more. What? Okay. So let's put upheaval. And we will put the healing factor, and we'll leave that right over there, and we will be continuing downwards. Some lag, okay. I can't remember. Oh yes, we did do the ancient forest, yes. We'll continue onwards. It looks like I can only have one upheaval totem. I presume that will increase as time goes on. So the totem build is actually quite an interesting build at the moment. You have to always keep track of your totems because... Yeah? Охран. Смерть. А, я слакали станки. Слайфа. Окей. Страх. Use a quiver, but that's fine. Online friends, let's see. Nobody really online at the moment. I say the upheaval totem really does not last long. So I've got upheaval, I've got thorn titan. I need a third titan, but I believe that will come into play once I have my next subclass. The relic now that I just received. So I'm gonna first clear out that's not going to help. Increase damage over time. I'm not doing dot, eh? See, drops. Fire damage, increased chance to find potions, gain haste for 3 seconds on potions use. Reduce minion damage, physical resistance and mana resistance. I lose a little bit of resistances, but yeah, I'm gonna need to get some physical poison. Necrotic A, yeah, those are the 3 that I need physical resistance for. So there's room for improvement at the moment. It feels weird not to actually be there one to actually attack. Really is a funny feeling. Throw the totems down and they do the attacking for you. So, let's just quickly confirm which way we will be going. Okay, so. Where did I stop off? Okay, base physical damage to cold damage. Poison and frostbite. And then, so I need one in here. So my next skill is gonna go in there. Then from there, I'm going to go to maximum health. And then as well as, oh, there is maximum totems. I can get more totems. Okay. Maximum upheaval totems. Additional charges. Okay, so this is going to help a lot. So I'll definitely go down this path for upheaval. And then from there onwards, I will go down to base to cold damage, freeze rate, and cast on Shatter. This is the area of attack. Okay, eternal protection, armor, no, anomaly. It's damage with active damage. You have a chance to summon a Thorn Totem. Ice Thorns deal more damage with other modifiers for each of your activations. Okay, so this is not really going to become a totem, but I gain damage with totems. Okay. So I'll definitely go down this path. So two extra in here, then three in there, and then we will add this Totem Weaver and Mystic Fury. Let's go to this ability right over here. Okay, so I've got 22 points. Natural resistance. Okay. Hunter's Restoration. Increased me. I'm not really doing minions. Let's see. Increased totems, health totems are immune to poison damage. I need then an additional 3 points before I will be able to get that. But I guess if we're going to go for totems, it's going to be worth the while. Worth the risk. Make sure that my totems last a little bit longer than usually. Okay, now I'm just running backwards. Interesting. Door that can be highlighted but can't enter it. Level 21. Because here I'll definitely get increased mana regeneration, armor activation, and then Totemic Fury. Okay. Yeah, I'm not really doing melee damage. Increased totem damage grounded per point. Increase spell damage for activated totem. Okay, druid. There's this totem over here. But I'm not going to go druid. Beastmaster doesn't have any totems. So shaman is the best bet for a totem build. Okay. Why does this area look so much different? Where am I? The ruined world. Okay, so now one additional totem. Definitely gonna go for the gold after I got this one. This is the ceiling thing. The Lumberbird gave a Trevor token with a... Okay, so I have to first cast the upheaval and then cast the Thorn Totem. Otherwise I can't use both of them at the same time. Really doing melee physical damage. Does do a lot of damage, but you really need to keep track. If you don't keep track, it doesn't really help. Ice Totem. Oh, I see thorns. I'm surprised this hasn't upgraded yet. Thought something attacked me from the back. Apparently not. Don't wanna die. One hit and I'm dead. Durability, need to get it up. rhythm is the gist. Maybe Titan balls get a lot better the longer you play. Maybe, not sure. One thing I can definitely say, it's definitely not easy. Trying things I'm not used to that game. Maybe I should concentrate like on one type of totem ball or totem and then hit it with the rest. Okay. Not too difficult. This thing is taking forever. Additional charges, okay. That makes it 3. What's this critical multiplier? Bleed chance, slow chance, double with two-handed weapons. Two-handed weapons does really actually count as a staff as well. So maybe it will be a little bit better with a staff. Does not scale with points allocated. It's understandable. Sure, I'd rather maybe first go for this. Base damage called. Base. It's already on 6. 3 totems. 3 upheaval totems. I think the whole idea of a totem board is to place the totems in strategic ways so so that we'll be able to not be completely encircled. When they attack. It does do a lot of damage though. Beasties, they're not following me. Interesting. Finally! Base damage converted to cold. Their durability is not there. I need to get it to be a lot more durable. Finally! A lot of button pressing. Just gonna take a look at something. Armor, increase mana regen, increase attack speed, primalist. Okay, so this is a totem, spell damage totem, tripled while using an axe. Does not scale with allocated points. Yeah, that's fine. And the spell damage is double. Increase totem health per point. Next ability goes in there. 8. Well, definitely my lightning and cold resistance is maxed out there. Increased spell damage, increased minion spell damage. Spell damage, totem spell damage. And increased totem health. Totems are immune to poison. That was Kale. Off points. Oh, okay. Travel to the Chamber of Councils. Let's ask the community. Enter. Which is better for which weapon? Weapon type is better for a totem build. Staff or wand? Let's see what they say.
Gold won't save you, the blade might.
Not really doing lightning damage, but I'll add it in just for. Temple of Terra. Talking about it, okay, so that's Impaler, Pulsar, Refresh. Okay, root staff. Titan? Nobody really is talking about it, so that doesn't really help, I guess. Unidentified purchased item. Oak armor. 32 armor, 32 armor. 1 to 2, 4 atonements. Forest cowl, wolf belt. Is there a way to inventory blessings, appearances? No appearance. Where is the FPS, there we go. That's per second. That's the chat. Gameplay, graphics, sound, social challenges. Gameplay. Change input keys. Usability, calibrate, restore to default, sheet, crafting menu, open settings is out, toggle user interface. Shift F11, zoom, that's fine. Loot filter. Manage filter. Drag drop rules to reorder them. Okay. Create a filter. Create a new filter. So, enter description. Okay. Titan plus one, maybe. Titan damage. That little icon right over there, and we will make it green. Okay, add condition. Item type. Idle accessory, two-handed weapons, staff. Okay. One-handed wand and scepters. Okay. Offhand catalyst. Yeah, it can. Boots, gloves, accessories, amulet rings and amulets and idols. Large idols, grand idols. The idols can be everything. Really not bothered about that. Okay, confirm. 21 selected, sub, add condition. Hide emphasize. Character level dependency rule, edit rule name. Doesn't really make sense. Library color, add condition none. Item type, I believe the previous one were types. So, affixes, mini spell throwing damage type, called. Elemental, cold penetration. I'm gonna try and not go for really physical elemental damage. Bow throwing spell, spell damage cost. Let's go for spell damage. Although I don't need casting speed. Right. Throwing health, defense. Added health, increase health. Add all the health. Block. Health gained on block. Block chance. Oh, I'm not gonna do that. Resistances and armor. Yeah. All resistances. Okay. Resistance potions. Health recovery. Health on kill. Health on. Health regen per second. Increase healing efficiency. Health regeneration. Okay. Ward stun. Stun avoidance. Leech melee. Leech, increase leech rate, lightning damage and leech, no. Movement, cooldown reflect, mana. Movement, yes, movement speed, please, movement speed, cooldown. Increase cooldown recovery speed. Minion ailments, chance to bleed on hit. Chance to blind on hit. Chance to chill on hit. Chance to chill attackers. Slow can work as well. Chance to slow attackers. Freeze rate multiplier. Chance to shred freeze rate per stack. Freeze rate multiplier and cold resistance. Okay. Primalist. Spell damage for totems. Increase cooldown recovery minion control strike multiplier with transformed cost speed on totems. Minions melee damage reduced on health, added minion damage. Totem critical strike. Increase totem damage. Armor shred, increase attack and cost speed summoned. Cooldown shade bleed duration. Level of swipe, summon wolf, level of tornado, level of fury leap, level of summoning thorn totem, frenzy totem, storm totem. That's up evil, not really frenzy. I'm gonna remove frenzy because I'm not doing a frenzy. Let's do this. Totem. Totem armor, totem health, totem elemental resistance, cost speed for total. Now this makes life a lot easier. Confirm. add. Okay. Loot filter has been pulled. Extra view items hidden by your filter. Okay, interesting. Physical resistance and lightning resistance. Cooldown recovery, health per regens. Increased critical strike chance. Increased damage over time, increased stun chance. Melee damage leech. Two plus strength. Sixteen forging potential. Increase fire damage, increase. Doesn't look like that actually really helped. Cold damage, increased fire damage, critical chances. too many buttons. Close. Okay. Increase total health with 20%. That is actually quite a lot. Level 66, gee Louise. So I haven't really seen anything dropped for specifically totems so far. Some moves really are just for multiplayer. There was a build that I tried out yesterday. I tried it to do a complete shield build, but failed because you can't really do a complete shield build at the moment with just playing single player. You have to play multiplayer because it's more of a tank build than a actual damage type build. Both of those tools are half and half the same as the shield tool. You don't need to. Yeah. I may be wrong, but it really does feel like it's a more of a team play build. You constantly run around and trying to on everything. I need to bring up my resistances as well. Okay, time to bypass everything. Bypass the run back.
Yes. feet.
Follow my feet? It's an ironic way to say it. Just follow your feet, it will lead you to the right path. Common item.
It's a thing about luck, though.
Plus void damage, increased damage over time, spell minus 3 cast. Yeah.
Interested in another try? Excellent choice.
Melee damage, spell damage. Increased physical damage. Let's do the following. Let's go to Forge. Add this thing in. Let's see. Cliff. Rune of Discovery. Adds a random tier 1 to all empty. Removes random affixes on items, returning a number of shards equal to its tier. Rerolls the values of all affixes on item with tier. Their tiers and destroys an item creating. Okay, so that's actually a fairly nice thing to have, but let's see. Increased elemental chance to slow and chance to ignite. Increased spell damage, increased minion damage. That's 15. Let's see if I've got anything for. Nothing for totem. Prefix, suffix, nothing. Increase physical damage, melee damage. Fire damage. Right.
Feeling lucky?
Really did not help anything. Okay. Level 25. Okay. Now... skill... this. Really cool damage of 200. Okay. That's 27 points. So I'm thinking of I'm gonna stop right here. And then... really, that does not help. That also doesn't help really that much. No, it's not Itra. Okay, there was some lagging like crazy. I really need to start getting my resistance up. Only experienced rubber band when I'm playing online. I haven't actually experienced it while I'm playing offline. It's kind of a little bit frustrating when you get rubber band. Like that. Jumps you back and forth. Wow. Is there not again a problem with the online play or what? Thank you. Vitality, health. Melee damage, necrotic damage, increase me in health, no, vitality, increase cold damage, reward chance, increase health regeneration and poison resistance. Okay, currently what am I getting? Lightning resistance is top notch. But my physical and poison resistance is still absolutely horrible. Lose lightning and void resistance. I can't really afford to lose lightning and void resistance. 156, 174. Armor, poison resistance, void resistance. Yeah, I can do that. I'm not really losing. Maybe dodge and health, but again, poison resistance and void resistance. Not just physical and necrotic. Necrotic is the main son of a gun that I need to concentrate on. Fire resistance is 31%. War damage. This was the easiest battle I've ever experienced. That was amazing. Cleaver, increased fire. Let's just pick everything up. Lightning resistance and void resistance. This thing is completely blank, so no resistances. So prefix, cost speed, cold damage, damage over time, elemental damage. I'm gonna add in elemental damage, and then we're gonna add in that little bad boy. 19. Okay, second one I'm going to do poison damage, no, cost speed, no, cold damage, I've already got cold damage. Damage over time, lightning damage, necrotic, poison, no, suffixes. And lightning resistance. Hey, hey. Cold dodge. Let's add in necrotic. Tier 1, tier 2. Can upgrade it to tier 2, can upgrade that to tier 2 as well, and I can upgrade that as well to tier 2. I can upgrade that to tier 3. Yes, necrotic damage. Tier 3, tier 3. Okay, I believe that will work out a little bit better, because now I just don't have physical resistances, but that is fine. Hey, is this game? Hey,
want to try your luck?
Strange. Wait. My back. Dang it. Dat is de verkeerde. Okay.
You seem a little this is what is left when you read whatever most of them he might be kind enough to show you how to tap into your true potential.
There's a rubber band. It's frustrating. Mastery shop.
Focus on the potential you wish to wield as I guide the shades to you.
The healing factory right over there. Okay, so that's avalanche. Okay. Earthquake. Aftershock appears around the totem. Back. Tornado. It's like the very first skill that you get. Avalanche. Storm totem. I believe. Let's remove this. Respec. The specialized skill, and then we add in specialize for storm totem. Slow amount, lightning. Storm totem creates a blizzard around itself. Enemies caught in the blizzard. Yeah, I'm gonna definitely go for cold, because even this. I'm gonna go for cold damage. This is also cold damage. Allies near your storm totem have the additional lightning resistance. Storm totem has increased health. Storm totem's increased cast speed. Improve storm totem's base critical strike. So this health is really going to help. Mana efficiency. So let's go for additional health, blizzard surrounding it. Then I have another 2 points left. Storm totem deals additional cold damage. Blizzard has a chance to inflict enemies with frostbite. Frostbite inflicts blizzard has additional cold damage. The question is, I'm gonna go like that. Okay.
I see. I be censured. They weep the eat. Seek out the outcast queen.
Ready.
The living rebels and show her the epoch. The rest will be up. You.
Okay. 345. Okay. So 1 point. Atonement penetration. Do you have an additional atonement? Attunement. You and your minions penetrate enemies' physical cold lightning resistance. Increase damage, increase minion damage. Additional armor increased. Increased mana regen with active totems. Increased cast speed with active totems. Now the actual question is, does totem, it's minion. So wait. If minion tags minion, so equipped items, spell damage gets increased by minion damage. So, have I gone completely wrong according to it? Increase minion damage. So I could actually respec these. Spell damage, increase totem health. I don't really have to increase that. I can remove those two. Minion. Maybe remove the spell damage a little bit. Minium totem attunement. Minium totem. Physical melee minion totem. I don't know that. I really did not know that. Okay, I guess that's how we learn. Totem scaled by a minion damage. I would have thought it would have been completely different. Let's swing keys, is it all the evil here? Gonna be bit them. Go. Come here. Klim daar, daar is hij. Minion spell and bow attacks your minions leech 10% increase minion. So now
Impossible. Impossible.
What do you want?
Impossible.
I should be yelling over there. Does lightning damage though? Let's do this. Yeah, that's actually what I wanted to do. Heal there, put storm there, and something I need to test out. So if I throw this and then this. Okay. So I have to put Storm Totem, Upheaval, and then. So I can throw that. I can throw. And then I can throw all of that. Because if I throw this, it removes my upheaval. Strange. Like I can only have one Storm Totem. Interesting. Really, really, really interesting. Thank you. Storm Titan does a lot of damage. I guess this is how we learn. Kom net by my checkpoint uit. Okay, we will be calling it quits today, well, for now. We'll continue onwards a little bit later tonight, and we will be continuing with our Sentinel build tonight. Thanks for watching. Please follow and comment if there's anything I can improve on my stream. Thank you for watching. Have a wonderful day. Bye.